Friedman, a civil rights attorney and law professor, and Richard Herman, a criminal defense attorney and law professor. Good to see you both.
Hi, Frederica.
All right, super disturbing accusations. So, Richard, if the accusation is true, you know, that DiSabato was saying that Congressman Jim Jordan asked students to keep quiet, what's the legal road ahead?
Well, that's just evidence of guilt. I mean, how could he have not known, Fred? Seriously, he was a wrestling coach for about 10 years at Ohio State when this animal doctor was doing this. You know, you're a wrestling coach. It's like family with your wrestlers. This doctor was targeting the wrestling team. He spoke with the wrestlers. Right. They spoke in the locker room. He shared a locker with the wrestlers. Everybody knew what was going on at Ohio State. The wrestlers thought this was hazing. They weren't even sure what this was all about. Mm. Yet, they complained. They told him. There are so many instances, Fred, of not only students, but a referee going up to Jordan and telling him. And what did he do? This man filled with fake rage, who takes his jackets off and screams and yells and doesn't say anything, screams and yells. That's what he does, Avery. Sorry, he's from Ohio, but that's what he does. Where's his rage now, Fred? Mm. Where's his rage now? Well, what was going on at his institution? He's a liar and a coward, Fred. That's what I'll say it to his face. He can call me anytime. A liar and a coward.
So then, hey, Avery, how will this be pursued? Because, you know, the brother of at least one accuser is saying, hey, this is what happened. Jordan has said, you know, something else. His statement also, you know, says, no, if he heard anything, he would do the right thing. But you've got one of the principals in this case, the doctor, who is deceased. So how does anyone get to the bottom of what happened and what should happen next?
Well, here's the answer to it. There was an enormous investigation in Ohio State. 177 kids, Frederica, were affected by the behavior of this doctor. 48 of 177 were on the wrestling team. And Dunyasha Yetz, who was mentioned in that piece with Allison, actually talked to Jordan, he says, under oath. The only reason it's surfacing now is there's a legislative hearing going on in Columbus trying to get rid of the statute of limitations so these kids can do something about the abuse. Mm-hmm. And what went on with that was Jordan said to Yetz, if Strauss makes a move on him, he'll kill him. So if you credit that, Frederica, if you credit that, clearly there's some implication there. Whether or not he's a coward or whether he's lying really ultimately gets sorted out in a lawsuit. Mm-hmm. And there are 350, as you mentioned, 350 cases pending. That's where the truth or not will surface. So we have a while to go to get right down to the issue.
And then, Richard, what about the university itself?
Yeah, that's the deep pocket here, Fred, of the 350 victims that have come forward as of now and the 1,500 acts of criminal assault on these young men. The deep pocket is the university. What did they know? When did they know? And as Avery said, the university commissioned an internal investigation, and the investigation results found that the university knew what was going on. They knew this doctor was conducting and carrying on and violating these students, and they did nothing. And that's the liability. And, the miscellaneous individuals that knew.
We've got to go to court to find out.
Right, and they're
trying to get in that courtroom. In fact, I have to
say, they knew when they knew, Fred, but their own investigation revealed they did know and they did nothing. And that's why this guy, Jordan, has zero integrity. He was charged to protect these students that he coached, and he turned his back on them, and he did nothing to protect them. 10 years, Fred, it's not one or two cases. 350 students. He did nothing. He's a coward.
So, Avery, do you